And justice, well, justice always triumphs. At least we'd like to think of it that way. But before we begin, the company wishes to express its appreciation to those who made this production possible, especially Johann Strauss, Victor Herbert, and Rudolf Hermann. And now it gives us the great pleasure to present the saga of Colorado, Little Mary Sunshine.
Thank you. Long march from the Mexican border left all the men puckered out.
At ease, gentlemen. Gentlemen, I'm afraid I have a piece of disappointing news. For since I sent Sergeant McGinty back to headquarters, against his will, I might add, I know how sorely you have missed his high administrations. I have just received word, be it Peregrine Pigeon, that your beloved top sergeant will be unable to rejoin the outfit for quite some time, for he's suffering from badly strained vocal cords. During his absence, Corporal Chester will remain second charge. Corporal!
Yes, sir.
Have you been studying your book of rules and regulations, Corporal?
Oh, yes, sir. It's my constant pain, sir.
Good. The book of rules and regulations is the finest companion a forest ranger ever had.
Indeed it is, sir.
And now, Corporal, take charge of the troop whilst I make billeting arrangements.
Troop, attention! Salute one!
When taking it over to command of the troop, be sure the men can depend on your courageous behavior. At ease, gentlemen. Whilst Captain Warrington is away, I'd like to talk to you a little bit about courage. Courage is something a man should have here in his heart. If he is to lead others, take me, for example. My all outward appearances may seem that I am not the courageous type. But dear, there's courage just there, and I'd like to prove it to you.
How?
How, you ask me? There doesn't seem to be any way I can prove it to you. You?
How, me Chief Brown Bear?
Excuse me one moment, Chief. Consider all Indians friendly unless mortally assaulted. Pleased to meet you, Chief. Pleased to meet you. You fellas all met Brown.
Me Chief Cadota Indians. Peace. Me bring peace from Cadota Indians to Forest Ranger.
We're glad to hear that. Tell me, don't you Cadotas live on a reservation?
Cadotas no live on reservation. All this belong Cadotas. All.
Does the United States know about that?
Fight many years to keep. Only two Cadotas left. Rest die fighting white men. Many white men die too.
How?
How? D.C. Washington. Settled case by law. Better to fight with tomahawk than lawsuit. But Mary Sunshine convinced me to do this.
Smart girl, Miss Mary.
Me meet her here each summer. She my adopted daughter. Me give her Indian name, Mary Sunshine. She Mary, like sunshine. So we call her Mary Sunshine.
That's very clever of you, Chief. You'll excuse me one moment. That's one fine, Miss Mary.
Stay. Here come Mary Sunshine now.
How?
No, now.
Sunshine.
truly sorry I even mentioned it.
Well, on the contrary, the bevy of young ladies is a welcome contrast to the poor stranger's usual diet of foreign fauna. We accept your hospitality, kindness, and only wish in some way we could help you in your present difficulty.
Present difficulty, dear corporal?
Was it not true, Miss Mary? You built this charming inn on exciting purchase from the United States government, the meager savings of your homemade cookies?
Indeed, that is quite true.
And is it not true that if you are unable to meet the payments on the land, the government will be forced to foreclose their mortgage?
That is quite true. But to what present difficulty do you refer?
Why, the mortgage, Miss Mary. If it is foreclosed, it will be cast out and payless.
In truth, I am surprised that you think that such a little thing as this would disturb me. I am but sorely grieved that it disturbs you. Listen.
Brief and fleeting they are, Miss Mary. Yet, dare I say, these infrequent meetings are an oasis in a vast desert of a poor horse ranger's lonely life.
I'm but pleased to learn that two hearts meet in this relationship. For indeed we are two dearest and truest of friends.
Friends, Miss Mary?
The very best, dear Captain.
Would that I were able to pursue the subject further. But when a man's life is in danger. I tell you, Miss Mary, from Canada to the Mexican border, a notorious band of Indians has ravaged the land of wild game and wantonly set the forest afire. Until now, they have evaded the hand of justice. But their hideout has been discovered not far from here. And it is my assignment to bring in their leader, dead or alive.
Oh, Captain Jim, I'm frightened for you.
And do not fret, Miss Mary, for if the Indian guide who will lead me there can be trusted, I have no fears. And tell me, do you by chance happen to know anything about a tribe of Indians called the Kadotas?
Kadotas? Oh, indeed I do. For when I was but just a tiny tot, I lost my way while berry picking in the forest. And I was found by the then savage Kadota Indians. I was taken to Chief Brown Bear, their leader, and he brought me up as his adopted daughter. Chief Brown Bear is the only father I've ever really known.
I see. Then you might know my guide. He goes by the name of Fleetfoot.
Fleetfoot? Oh, he's the very Indian guide who found me in the forest and saved my life. Oh, a finer Indian guide you couldn't find. And after being trusted, well, I'd save my life on it. Oh, I'm so relieved, Captain Jim. Fleetfoot is Indian father's closest friend. The bond is very deep. They're the only two Kadotas left.
The only two?
The only two. Oh, how happy Indian thought will be to learn of Fleetfoot's arrival.
For the present, Miss Mary, I would prefer to keep Fleetfoot's arrival a deep secret.
Oh, then my knowledge is a sealed book, dear Captain.
And now, Miss Mary, with Fleetfoot's arrival imminent, would it be audacious of me to ask for your dear companionship?
Audacious? Well, it's the very least a woman can do. Would you care to stroll in my garden? So many flowers have blossomed and bloomed since last year.
Well, I know and love your garden, Miss Mary. Yet before we slander into that piece of loveliness, my honest nature brings a confession from me.
A confession, Captain Jim?
A confession, Miss Mary. sounds like someone singing.
Well, then it is someone singing, and I recognize that glorious voice anywhere. Madam Ernestine von Gift.
Oh, my liebchen, my pupchen. You missed her hike with me today, yeah?
Oh, do forgive me, madam, but a dear friend of mine unexpectedly.
Hear you to echo of the singing?
Oh, very clearly, madam.
To echo is always to sing. It matter not there. It take me back to my kinderhood. Yeah, yeah. How often does to kinder I make to echo?
Madam, I would like you to meet a very dear friend of mine, Captain Warrington.
Captain Big Jim Warrington at your service, madam.
Just an unexpected friend, yeah? It's pleasure to meet you, Captain. My liebchen speak of nobody else all the day long, so I say to her liebchen, it's time you get this captain to think of the marriage.
Madame Ernestine is our most celebrated guest. We consider it a great honor that she chooses to spend her leisure with us.
It's much like your homeland here, and we all long for the home, yeah?
Tell me, Captain.
Then you settle down with five.
Captain Warrington leads a very active life. You see, as a forest ranger, he can't stay in one place for very long.
Just as bad, Captain. The life of the singing and the gypsy is not for you. You need your home to bite and to kinder. And right now you need to hike. You look tired, Captain, very tired. A nice long hike with your leechin to talk over these things, that make you feel much better.
But Madame Ernestine, Captain Warrington has just marched from the Mexican border.
Yo!
Always be here in my heart. In been a most noble one, and we wish to thank you.
Thank you.
But when a young lady has been brought up with a standard of... Blanche, are you willing that young man to whisper in your ear?
I'm afraid so, Cora.
Have we forgotten who we are?
Young ladies from Eastchester Finishing School.
But couldn't we forget it just for this once?
For we are, really.
We are socially prominent and ever so rich.
I am more than willing to concede it would not be difficult to form an attachment to one of these young men. But we must be strong, for it is the weak link that breaks the chain. And I think we should form a pact immediately.
But Cora, a pact would have to be all of us. And that scarcely seems fair, now does it?
How do you do?
How do you do?
Would you be good enough to engage us in conversation?
And what is the nature of the conversation in which you wish to engage us?
Well, you see, we've been having an argument amongst ourselves, and we can't decide if you are as beautiful and lovely as you seem, or if you are, on the whole, rather plain.
Rather plain?
Yes, rather plain. You see, we've been away from feminine companionship for such a long time, we feel in judging one's feminine attributes, we may be, for the moment, overly indulgent.
And far as ranges being the good-looking dog that they are, must necessarily associate with young ladies of comparable appearance.
It's one of the forest rangers' unwritten laws.
Would you mind repeating that question just once more?
Well, Mom always liked to see me happy.
Well, that's it.
intend to let you go. Dismissed.
Oh, Billy, how masterful you were. Just for that, I'm going to give you a big welcome home kiss.
Don't come any closer. You might as well go right now. We're through. Finished.
Washed up.
But Billy, that's the way we were the last time you left. I want to change it all back again.
So I see. I'm just a puppet on a string dancing to your tune, as it were. Well, it won't do, Nancy. It won't do at all.
Oh, Billy, I promise I won't so much as look at another man ever again.
If you only knew how much I wanted to trust you.
Do you really mean that?
Of course I do, Billy.
I don't believe you.
Captain? No, no. In yonder tree, my little
to marry.
Well, I shan't moment. We can't have you go hungry, can we?
Thank you, Corporal. That should give us time for the brief chat I want to have with you.
Yes, sir.
In a short while, I trust a guide will be here to take me to the notorious band of Indians for whom we have searched so long. During my absence, I want you to take command of the troop.
Yes, sir.
Until 9 o'clock this evening.
Until 9 o'clock, sir.
It is my assignment to bring in their leader, dead or alive. As a forest ranger, I intend to appeal to a sense of honor. For his accomplices shall be disbanded and freed. But should I not return by 9 o'clock, it will then become your duty to apprehend this killer by more devious means.
My duty, sir?
The guide will return to take you to his hideout. And there, disguised as an Indian brave, you will join their campfire unnoticed. You will wait for the proper moment to strike. Then, bang! You will hold the others at bay while you take their leader to justice. You'll be our hero, Corporal.
Me, sir?
If it works.
You sure some of the other fellows don't want to come along? I don't want to hog all the glory.
It's a one-man job, Corporal. Should I not return, you have my personal good wishes for your success. But should you fail, then you too will have the pleasure of knowing you have not died in vain. We will have died for a noble cause.
I feel better already, sir.
Ah, but I see Dearest Mary approaching. You're dismissed, Corporal Jester.
Drunken orgy with a wanton woman. He knifed a man who accused him of cheating at cards. They took him to jail, but with his usual craftiness, he escaped and came here. You see, he is by tribal custom a brother of mine. But I refused him in his lawlessness. So when the sheriff and his men, they followed him here, he leaped over Point Lookout into the river below. Though his body was never found, we presumed him dead. I told Indian Father that he died while trying to save my life so that he could remember his own honor. Oh, if Chief Brown Bear were to tell me the truth, it would break his poor old Indian heart.
It is possible he need never know. Rest assured, Miss Mary, I shall do everything in my power to spare him his knowledge.
I do appreciate your concern for Chief Brown Bear.
It would be dishonest of me were I not to say my main concern in this matter is for your peace of mind, Little Mary.
My peace of mind, Captain?
I have but a few moments before I must leave, Little Mary. And I...
Oh, how silly of me! Your refreshments! I'll get them at once.
Stay, Little Mary. I must be heard. For my refreshment, my feast, is meant to be near you.
Captain Jim!
How many goodbyes we've said in the past? Yet this time, my heart will be still no longer. Little Mary, if I return, will you be mine?
Be yours?
Oh, I know I am not worthy to ask the hand of the dearest, the fairest, the loveliest flower that God ever gave to brighten this whole world of ours. But I ask for your hand all the same.
Oh, Captain Jim, I had not allowed myself to hope. I would not allow myself to think. Yet sometimes, in my wildest dreams, I secretly dare to pretend that this happy moment would occur. Oh, God! I am yes. A thousand times yes.
Oh, Little Mary.
Yes?
If I return.
Oh, when you return.
When I return. Here, we shall share our life together. And I shall be the happiest man alive.
And I, a woman fulfilled.
Every soul we knew how.
Ciao, Billy Chester. Say ki ciao, Billy Chester. Raho me da kocha. Shante ka dota. Shante ka dota.
Oh, here it is. Desertion. Desertion from the United States Forest Rangers. Punishable by life imprisonment. Death before a firing squad. Or both. Or both. Say, Chief, I didn't see that.
Me pray, great sky spirit.
I'll wait outside the service is over.
Me finish.
Tell you the truth, I'm kind of glad I ran into you. I was hoping maybe you could fix me up in an Indian city.
Me ask great sky spirit if me should make you my son.
Your son? What do you have to say?
Great sky spirit say yes. Great sky spirit say good for Kadota future. We hope real son carry on tradition of Kadota tribe. Real son die hero. Go happy hunting ground.
See, that's too bad. I'll make two of us right in a row.
Two?
We gotta go on a little secret mission tonight. Nothing big. We'll come back alive.
You be safe. Me give charms.
Charms?
Me give you Indian dress fit for son of chief. Come teepee when moon come over mountain. We have ceremony. There you become my dead son reborn. Me give you his Indian dress to wear. You become Yellow Feather.
Kadota!
Kadota!
Yeah, that's better. Kadota! See you tonight, Chief.
Sleep in teepee many years. No cold, no ache, no pain. White man have all. Why two Indians here?
Two Indians? There are no two Indians here. You must be mistaken.
No mistake. Two Indians here.
Oh! Now that you mention it, there was another Indian here. There was an Indian guide that came to take and captain Warrington on a mission.
And other?
No other.
Yes, other Indian here. We know. We feel. It's very still. Too still. Bad sign. If bad happened, Mary Sunshine, you run faster than wind to teepee of Indian father. Kadota.
Kadota, Indian father.
Every dumb rat deep needs a precious man to know.
seem to be making up for the both of us.
But isn't that what a party's for? To have fun?
Oh, yes, indeed it is. You have your friends with all those
other men. Why, I risk my life on a secret mission.
A secret mission? Doing what?
That's what's secret about it. I probably shan't come back, you know.
Well, if you're not coming back, why can't you tell me?
I'll tell you this much. You meet a mysterious Indian and I don't scream. It's me.
Oh, disguises? I just love disguises!
Well, I guess this is it, old girl. If I return, I shall make you mine. And if not, I want you to have this.
A Billy! A pawn ticket!
It's all my grandmother's wedding ring.
It's lovely, Billy.
Chin up, old girl. We're there.
Goodbye, Billy.
You take good care of yourself now.
Don't you worry about me, old girl.
I know where I'm going.
Whoa! Oh, I'm sorry. Do excuse me.
Oh, well.
Well, goodbye!
Must be getting serious.
I do hope little Mary's emotional condition is much better.
Yes, the poor thing, she was shaken up, wasn't she?
And do you know it's not a play on John? She looked to see me.
I'm surprised the poor dear came down to the party at all.
Shh, don't say another word. Here she comes now.
Will you?
Nothing has happened.
Good evening, girls. I do hope you're having a pleasant time.
Oh, never mind us, you poor thing, you.
Perfectly terrible. What has happened to you?
We're dreadfully upset for you.
Oh. Well, I'm quite all right now, thank you.
Oh, how brave of you.
Yes, the courage of you Western women.
I'm sure I could never be so composed if my fiancé had left my side on some unknown dangerous mission.
Probably never to return.
Well, I'm sure he'll be that late this evening.
But if he shouldn't return, feel free to call on us.
We'll cheer you up, dear.
Thank you. I do appreciate your kindness.
Ha ha ha!
Whatever could that be? It sounds like an auto touring car.
Ha ha!
Now tell me, who's
and I'll recommend you for a promotion.
Yes, sir.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry to disrupt your party in this way, but it's most urgent that Captain Warrington be found.
Oh, God bless you, General. You're heaven's angel.
Into your battle dress, men, and on your return, I shall split the troop into two search parties. Troop dismissed.
Oh, General Fairfax.
Oh, well. What have we here?
Will they be gone long?
Not long enough, my dear. Not long enough.
Oh, General, will it be dangerous?
Oh, reasonably so, my darling. Reasonably so.
Whatever shall we do?
Oh, there. Don't you worry your pretty little head about that. Uncle Oscar will keep you amused.
Uncle Oscar?
Oh, yes. I want you all to look on me now as your dear Uncle Oscar. And what might your name be?
That's Mabel.
Mabel doesn't say very much.
Mabel, you're the smartest female I ever met. Now, would you be kind enough to fetch me my goodie box?
A goodie box?
All manner of goodies for that little girl's love. And I must confess that I love to give little things away, particularly to little girls. Oh, well, thank you, my dear. You've done very well. Very well indeed. Now, just wait 1 minute here. Let me see. Well now. Ah, just the thing. Now, this is for you. And let me say, well now, here's a little trinket for you.
Wow.
And I have just the thing for you. No, you must let me pin it on you.
Girls?
Eh?
Give the presents back.
Give the presents back?
Young ladies from Eastchester Finishing School cannot accept gifts from single gentlemen.
Oh, but my dear, I've been married several times.
Well, even so, it isn't proper.
Oh, but it is. Now remember, for all practical purposes, I'm your dear old Uncle Oscar, an intimate member of the family, so to speak. There's a saying that it's better if we give than if we take. And I want to give, but etiquette says no. I can't carry out his letter, and its form I must forsake. But I've kept the spirit proper, as I'll show. And so, think of me as a kind and loving uncle. Oh, take the pleaser, right the squeeze, you'll take the end till you all say, I'm
that I, Oscar Fairfax, of the Philadelphia Fairfaxes, tried to force his gifts on young ladies who are in a highly advanced state of betrothal. Why, if I were your intended, I'd horsewhip me. That's what I do. I would horsewhip me. Mabel, to think of what we could have meant to each other. Well, you just keep smiling, dear.
Done with fire water. Feather. Indian belt.
Wow, that's pretty neat. Tell me, Chief, what are all the little furry things?
White man scalps. Best present last. Bow and arrow. Very fine. We have many, many years.
Say, Chief, really? I didn't.
You take. You're my son now.
Wow. This is a gym day. You have to teach me how to use this thing.
Tomorrow. Tomorrow me teach. Me teach you ride Indian pony too. Bareback.
Bareback? Now, wait a minute, Chief.
Tonight me pray to Great Sky Spirit. I thank Great Sky Spirit for bringing me son.
Chief, I got some presents for you too. And first, my pocket knife.
Pocket knife?
Yeah, it's got all kinds of uses. Cut with it, eat with it, fingernails. And, rules and regulations for a board finger. It's the finest companion a man ever had. And, my necktie.
Necktie?
Yeah. You wrap it around your neck, Chief. What it does, it sort of gives you that dress up.
My son gives me presents. My son gives me necktie. Very good son. Me wear necktie always.
Boy, it looked good. Me like.
Me like. Now you got me talking that way.
Eagle brain take effect. Quick laugh.
Well, you know what, Chief? Me glad to.
Be a big canoe to ancient Billy Crew. Out there,
it is.
Not very sad.
Even poor Mabel finds it difficult to smile, don't you, Mabel?
Perhaps we shouldn't have left the party.
How can you feel like a party, dear, when your loved one has left your side?
Who?
Your loved one, dear, your husband-to-be.
Oh, yes, I almost forgot.
Excuse me, girls.
What? Whatever are you doing?
I'm making my escape.
Your escape from where?
Oh, from here.
Why are you leaving now?
I don't want anyone to see.
Oh.
Something very mysterious is going on out there, and I'm going to find out what it is.
All I need is a suitable disguise.
Are you really going to go out there?
Well, of course I am. I'm going out and help Billy. Do you want to come along?
No. Just think what might happen to a girl.
That's what I've been thinking about.
There, I guess I've got everything I'm going to need.
Oh, Nancy, you make Sin sound like such fun.
Well, I wouldn't want to be a corrupting influence. Fatima, anyone?
Oh. No.
Well, good gracious me. I should have thought that you ladies would be tucked away in your trundles by now. It's very difficult when our loved ones, our husbands-to-be, have left their side.
Probably never to return.
We're hoping for a piece of news.
One way or the other.
Nancy's going into the night to find out all about it.
Nancy?
Nancy, are you hiding behind that tree over there?
We can't condone her headstrong ways, but yet she makes our lives so gay.
Naughty, naughty Nancy, you're so mischievous.
killed some wild Indians about, how unseemly of me to arrive at such a time.
It is nothing. A sort of exercise it is to me, the constant comrade, like the breezing. Do you breeze, General Fairfax?
Oh, you know my name. Have we met? Oh, no. I'm sure I could not have forgotten so fine a face and figure as yours.
Oh, very hospitable friend, General Fairfax. And I put spy and spy together.
Then you must be the famous Madame Ernestine von Lippertek.
Madam, it is a privilege and an honor to meet you face to face. how well I recall your Carmen.
That's my favorite role. I was the first person ever to sing Carmen in German. I premiered it in Vienna. Uh-huh. It made me overnight success.
Vienna.
Know you Vienna, General?
Believe it or not, Madame Ernestine, I was once a struggling young painter in Vienna. My family gave me a year to find out I wasn't a painter. Well, actually, I found out much sooner, for the only painting I ever sold was one my landlady hung upside down by mistake. I was forced to change the title from the mountain to the valley. That was quite a year. Vienna, 1884.
84? That's the very year I come from the homeland to study the voice.
You were in Vienna then? I wonder if we could have met. Tell me, have you by any chance, did you frequent the Blue Danube Cafe?
Oh, I only know from the outside looking in. I'm very poor, Dick. I spend all the money on the voice lessons. Perhaps you go to the lovely free chamber music concert.
No, I must confess, I wasn't one much for chamber music.
Did you spend any time at the Red Stocking?
The Red Stocking? Oh, I was much too proper young lady for the Red Stocking. At the State Museum.
Much too impetuous for the State Museum. Oh, madam, I am so sorry we missed each other.
Yeah, it's pity. Yet, Vienna was many things, too many people, but each had their own happy memory.
I do.
Remember that story.
return. Me keep promise. Yellow Feather always keep promise. You don't have me see Yellow Feather?
Let me go, please let me go.
No, Mary Sunshine. We wait a long time. We wait very long time.
What do you want? What do you want?
We want you, Mary Sunshine. We have you now.
By the power invested in me by the government of the United States of America,
by the United States of America, it is my duty to inform you that our Supreme Court has reached a decision in the suit brought against my government by you and the Dakota tribe. The court has decided in your favor. We are therefore returning to you and your people approximately one quarter of the state of Colorado. Your deed, sir.
Justice triumph. Cardona honor restored. Now may give land away. First, to adopted daughter Mary Sunshine, may give this ground where stand Colorado in. Now she burned mortgage. All rest me give to new adopted son, Yellow Feather.
Gee, Dad.
Me give in hopes he make refuge for animal and tree, so that noble ranger will have place to call home.